वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, वी आर नाउ स्टडिंग द सब्जेक्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस, इन विच वी आर स्टडिंग द पार्ट फॉर्जिंग, एंड इन फॉर्जिंग वी विल सी रोल फॉर्जिंग. इट इज़ ए फॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस यूज्ड टू रिड्यूस द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ द सिलेंडर और रेक्टेंगुलर रॉड by passing it through a set of opposing rolls that have matching grooves with respect to the desired shape of the final part. It combines both rolling and forging, but classified as forging operation. Depending on the amount of deformation, the rolls rotate partially, roll forged parts are generally stronger and possess desired grain structure compared to machining that might be used to produce the same part. In figure we will see the rolling forging in which two rollers are given there. They are rotating opposite to each other. Then workpiece is given, rolls are given, guide flange. There is a guide flange to guide the roller. The side view of the rolling forging is shown by end view, and the side view is given. Orbital forging. In this process, forming is imparted to the workpiece by means of cone-shaped upper die that is simultaneously rolled and pressed into the work. The work is supported on the lower die. Because of the inclined axis of cone, only a small area of the work surface is compressed at any stage of forming. As the upper die revolves, the area under compression also revolves. Because of partial deformation, contact at any stage of forming, there is a substantial reduction in press load requirement. We will see in the figure the orbital path of upper die axis. Force is given by quantity F. Workpiece is given. Lower die is shown in the figure. The side view of the figure is given. Contact area between upper die and work. Isothermal forging. It is a hot forging operation in which the work is maintained at some elevated temperature during forming. The forging dies are also maintained at the same elevated temperature by avoiding chill of the work in contact with the cold die surfaces. The metal flows more radially and the force requirement is reduced. The process is expensive than conventional forging and is usually meant for difficult to forge metal like TI super alloys and for complex parts shapes. The process is done in vacuum or inert atmosphere to avoid rapid oxidation of the die material. Extrusion. Now we will see the part extrusion. Extrusion is the bulk forming process in which the work metal is forced or compressed to flow through the die. hole to produce a desired cross sectional shape. Example, squeezing toothpaste from the toothpaste tube. Advantages. Variety of shapes are possible, especially using hot extrusion. Grain structure and strength properties are enhanced in cold and warm extrusion. Close tolerances are possible mainly in cold extrusion. Types of extrusion: direct or forward extrusion, indirect or backward extrusion. Direct extrusion: a metal billet is first loaded into a container having die holes. A ram compresses the material, forcing it to flow through the die holes. Some extra portion of the billet will be present at the end of the process that cannot be extruded, and it is called butt. It is separated from the product by cutting it just beyond the exit. Now we will see the direct extrusion. In direct extrusion, ram is given. Ram is forced with forceps and velocity V. Work billet is present. Container is there. Final work shape is produced. And the two dies are present in between container. Indirect extrusion, a significant amount of friction exists between the billet surface and the container walls as the billet is forced to slide towards the die opening. Because of the presence of friction, a substantial increase in the ram force is required. In hot direct extrusion, the friction problem is increased by the presence of oxide layer on the surface of the billet. The oxide layer can cause defect in the extruded product. In order to address these problems, a dummy block is used between the ram and the work billet. The diameter of the dummy block is kept slightly smaller than the billet diameter, so that a thin layer of billet containing the oxide layer is left in the container, leaving the final product free of oxides. Then we will see making hollow shapes using direct extrusion. Hollow sections, the figure shows the container. In between container there are two dies. Then ram is given in the container which jerks on the work, final work shape with velocity V and force F. Then there is a mandrel which is also present in the container. Hollow sections like tubes can be made using direct extrusion setup shown in our figure. The starting billet is prepared with the hole parallel to its axis. As the billet is compressed, the material will flow through the gap between the mandrel and the die opening. Indirect extrusion. In this type, the die is mounted on to the ram and not on the container. As the ram compresses the metal, it flows through the die hole on the ram side, which is in opposite direction to the movement of the ram. Since there is no relative motion between the billet and the container, there is no friction at the interface, and hence the ram force is lower than in direct extrusion. Limitations: lower gravity. Limitations: lower gravity, rigidity, lower rigidity of the hollow ram, difficult in supporting the extruded product at the exit. Direct, indirect extrusion is shown in the figure, solid billet and hollow billet. In this figure, we will see the ram, which is forced with force F and velocity V. Then the die is present in between the container. Hollow ram is given. Final work shape is produced, and work ballot is given. Then second figure is solid billet and hollow billet, in which the container is present in between. The ram is present. The force is given to ram. The shape of the ram is different from the in solid billet extrusion. The ram is forced by force F and velocity V. There is a die present. Work billet is present. Final workpiece with desired shape is produced in this extrusion.